Dango in Japanese has both two meanings. One is sort of like a dumpling, but the other meaning is anything rounded form. They call it dango shape. It's rounded. So first time I made this little thing, it's rounded. And then in Omaha, when I enlarge a big piece, I mean a rounded form into a big shape, we started to call it like a sort of nickname. Dango, and then it became sort of a formal name for the type of work I'm doing. For some reason, while I'm thinking, this rounded form came up in my mind. So I made a second piece, second time I made a really big piece. So people remember my large piece much better than small piece. That's an issue for all sculptors. You have to realize this piece is about drying about 5 months in the studio. So, if you're a painter, you pull the canvas out and then you think about it, and then you have to make a decision next hour or within a day or something. But I'm looking at this shape casually about 5-6 months as it dries. And then lots of thought goes through, and then I pick one idea. I mean, if you're a painter, you don't talk about, drying speed of your oil paint to gain the depth of it and stuff. But in ceramics, it's so almost endless. Sometimes it's dangerous because technical part itself is so amazing and interesting. So some people get trapped in that and then forget about the creative part of it. It's a balance between the knowledge and technical part, and then to your own creative necessity is a pretty tricky thing. You just have to do it and then find out where is healthy balance for yourself. It is important to really bring in your individual characteristic into your technical part of it. Otherwise, you end up slave of technique.